In this video, we will be going over the object picker that we have in Gather. You can see here that I am in the See All category, where you will be able to find all of our items. On the left-hand side, we do have some other categories as well. Feel free to explore and familiarize yourself with the different types of objects that we do offer. Some of the objects in the categories towards the bottom are going to be our holiday or limited edition objects, and you can also search for specific objects to see if we do offer those using the search bar at the top. A little bit further down on the left hand side, you'll see the insert text button. This is where you can insert custom text that you can put on the floor, signs, walls, wherever you see fit. And then below that, you'll see the upload new button, where you can upload a custom design, which we do dive a little bit further into in one of our other YouTube videos. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to be staying in the See All category up here. Some objects, if I'll just select this apple here, some objects can be rotated. You can also select other color variants as well if you'd like to do that. And then our advanced objects, that would be an object that you could interact with. Any object, for the most part, can be made into an advanced object. So an advanced object is something that you do have an interaction attached to in some way. So down here, you'll see the object interactions. Right now, the apple is just selected as no interaction. But if you wanted to embed a website, image, video, external call like Zoom or a WebEx call, or just write a note in there. So if someone approaches that object, they'll be able to see the written note that goes along with it. If you do select something like the embedded video, you'll see you cannot select or you cannot click select object until all required fields are filled out. The required fields would be labeled with this little asterisk here. And then you can also increase or decrease the activation distance. We have a few other advanced options down here as well. For the most part, unless it's like a video or a document that you want to become available at a specific time, you wouldn't really touch this too much if you want the action to be available all the time. But feel free to play around with that as well, especially if you do have something that's supposed to start or stop at a specific time. Some objects are going to be seen just right off the bat as an interactive object. So as an example of that, I'll type in TV here. You'll see if I click TV, it's going to have embedded video selected already. That's because generally if you put a TV in your space, you could either select no interaction and place that TV as just a decoration. Or what you could do is you can take a video from YouTube or Vimeo, and you could then embed the video in here using the embedded link that you can get from that platform wherever the video is hosted. I hope this helps, and happy gathering.